just a few minutes worth. You know, this is running pretty fast. Pretty fast. So, yeah, but you can definitely see the equatorial bands there. I don't see any great red spots. Kind of hard to tell. I don't see any shadows. I don't see any other moons or anything. Although we probably wouldn't be able to see any of the moons, but might be able to see shadows. But yeah, I'm not seeing anything there at all. But yeah, I'll just grab a couple of minutes worth here. So yeah, had a good observing run. I actually got three more binary stars, 200 exposures of one, and then 100 exposures of two others. So I'll be able to definitely see how my photometric measurements on that compares. Now the tracking here is doing really well, so yeah, I can't account for my poor tracking otherwise. But yeah, there's Jupiter. I think what I'll do too is I'll goose up the exposure time and get some images of those moons, although they're pretty speckly. So there's almost 2 minutes worth. There is 2 minutes worth. Maybe I'll run it for about 3 minutes and then switch to longer exposure time. So there's Jupiter live. This is it's a little after 6 hours UTC on May 9th, 2018. Jupiter is at opposition. So this is an opposition observation here. So very cool. Hope you're enjoying it. Hopefully it's relatively visible. I'll run it through that. I think the software that everybody likes to use, this is software called Registax, and that'll do some things. The other thing I can do too is what's called Lucky Imaging, and that'll just grab sort of the best ones out of here. Okay, well that's three.